Whoa. Oh, welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. Sounds like someone just got hit with a cipher spell. The one that pushes back.
Yeah.
I forget what it's called. I haven't used it in a while. Amplified thrust went on over there. It's fighting. Anyway, there was a false ending at the end of the last episode. I had noticed on the map that we had a cave here, so we actually discovered the cave by walking to the edge of the cliff, but obviously we have to go, I guess, around this way to get to it. So you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna head up this way.
Sure.
And explore some more. This is an ice tower that we can't get into, apparently. There are things like specters and shenguilas, or however the hell you say it here. Ooh, a hidden thing. What? I already saw it.
And the fire shows me something new.
We saw that already. Before he saw it. Before he found it. That's not the way it's supposed to go. Ooh. Durgan Iron Ingot. This cast pig iron ingot has been lightly refined in preparation for eventual use in Durgan steel. Without the fire of the White Forge, it has little value. Cool. And Durgan cogwheels. 60 of them. Good thing we don't have encumbrance in this game. The settlements across the White March used a variety of bronze coins as currency. These cogwheels were used in Durgan's battery, where they were created in a two-part process. The distinctive cog-shaped planchettes were cast in bronze. While cooling, they were stuck in iron dies. The coins are still quite valuable in the Eastern Reach due to their high copper content. Cool. So is this currency? Or are these for use in practical use, practical applications? Well, that's a quest item, the Durgan Iron Ingot. Excellent. One thing we don't have to find later. That's gonna make us go around that way for some reason. Ooh, Skeletani. Oh, and stuff. There's a Lagufaeth thingy. Can I shoot from here? I bet yeah, I can't.
Yes?
Neil, let's go up here and handle these things. If this is the only way up... Of course, they might be going the way of least resistance.
Let's go!
This is going to be a mighty battle, isn't it?
Let's go!
Alright, shoot these first. Oh my god! Aloth? Not good. Wow. This might be a mistake because he might die again immediately.
Following your lead.
Can I ringleader these guys? It takes so long to cast. Oh crap.
Let's
Oh my god, our priest is down. This is insane. I guess she used it and he died again. Okay, let's keep him dead. We can't help him. He's dead. We can't heal anyone else. I'm trying to quit out of this. Okay. I don't think we can survive this without our healer. Doesn't he have two clear outs? These things need to go. Lagufaeth, right? Lagufaeth, Sidewinder. She's gonna heal herself. I don't know if we succeeded in this. Theodes activates ringleader. Okay, Lagufaeth. Oh, that's our friend Iceblight. Okay, good. Mind blades. Boom. Okay, you gotta run in now and help.
Eh?
There's another one here? My god. She's not doing anything. Okay, I don't think these ice blights are really the problem here.
Hey.
Oh my god. Now why does she only have two? Is it like taking away our powers or something? Lay on hands. On Theodas. And these three hit that. Clear out thingy. Actually, no, belay that. Can I can just knock it down. That was tough. That was tough. These guys are tough. I better watch out. Wow. Agates, livers, clubs, everything you could want. Wow. That was insane.
Time to see and not be seen.
Let's snuggle in here. Get some rest. Let's grab some more here. Fine padded armor and 73 more of these Durgan cogwheels. This brazier looks large enough to have held a signal fire once. That was brutal. We should have stocked up on supplies before we came out here. Yeah, I'm gonna be safe and save here because we can end up dead at the next fight like that. Alright. Things sure are colorful. Let's just go back down. Doesn't look like it does. So let's head back. Because I do want to explore that side of the map before I start going down to this cave.
Laying low.
The hell? There's a bunch of them. Lagufaeth, Redfin. Lagufaeth. Did we ever look up what these things are in the bestiary? I haven't looked in the bestiary for quite a while. Or bestiary, however you say it. Lagufaeth are territorial four-armed amphibians, though their thick skin protects them from the cold climate of the White March. They tend to favor hot springs. Lagufaeth are communal wilder with rudimentary weapons, but a natural aptitude for magic. They are especially dangerous in the mountains, where storms and snowfall may hide their presence from travelers until it's too late. They can remain under ice for extended periods of time and have been known to surprise unwary fishermen. A Lagufaeth Redfin is a dominant, mature Lagufaeth. They may be male or female. A Lagufaeth that transitions into a Redfin develops a reddish-brown tint to its skin and a bony crest atop its head. They are rarely the oldest member of a group, but they are the most aggressive, and they are typically responsible for defending a nest or group. When a Lagufaeth Redfin loses status, its crest falls off and its skin returns to a shade of blue, green, or purple. This might be our end here. Because we didn't find this one. It was a sidewinder and two of the Lagufaeth, and who knows if there's more back there.
Following your lead.
Let's go!
Wow, these things are fast. Oh, we have damaged it already, though. Ayla should get away from it. Oh, there's a lesser frost ooze. I'm not sure if I had him cast that last time. It died pretty quickly. Who's this? That's a dare. Okay, good. Knock him down. Because he's going to attack our wizard. If he knocks him down, the wizard can run. Without fear of reprisal. Integration. Let's see how this plays out. You gonna knock him or what? We can't knock him down? Ayla didn't cast a spell yet, just wait a sec. Blessing. Oh, we got him. Okay, good. Okay. How may you help? Go over here. Oh my god. About noxious burst for these things. definitely making contact with one of them. Wake up, Palagina. Mind blades. They can be knocked down. Oh my god, Kanna. Lay hands. And our best heal. Oh, he's paralyzed. Never mind. Let's hope the lay hands work. Lay hands is work. Okay, you hit that one. Then some more fireballs. Or some fireballs. Boom. Canna's up to two. If he can come survive one more chant round, he can summon some skeletons. Actually, Kanna. Push of major endurance. Never mind, he's out. Alright, we'll go back to attacking and killing stuff. Kill this one, near death. Nice, down. Oh, Kanna's back! Kanna is back! Take your potion. Take your medicine if you know what's good for you. Another fireball. Hopefully get that ooze before it moves too far. Oh, we killed the oxen. Awesome. Awesome, awesome. Did you take your potion? Take your freaking potion. Lay hands. We've got a lot of stuff back, so ignite that soul. You know what? Apparently we've only got two left. One's almost dead. Oh, hold on. Kanna, you're using your bare hands again. What an idiot. Aloth? What the hell? Are you trying to cast your... Oh, we're all... Here. That's the last one? Oh, never mind. Oof. All the usual stuff. Ooh, four amethysts.
Got it.
These are like smoking anthills or tiny volcanoes or something. Another amethyst. Oh, there's something over here.
I'll see what I can find.
Ringer berries. Some tough battles. Torn pack? Oh. You mean a pack as in that holds something, not a pack of an animal? Look at these guys with a torn pack. Tubes of stiff, frozen mud rise from the ground, and warm air buffets your face as you peer into them. You see shiny, jagged shards inside. Jagged shards of what? This is the unknown, people. Blood moss. Ooh. The thermal pearl. I found the hot springs northwest of the road. Now I'll have to search for them for thermal pearls. You'll say for them thermal pearls. You peer into this pool. The water is perfectly clear, but you don't see anything of note. Cool.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
For some reason, it brings us out of sneak when we do that. Yeah, I guess we've explored all this. You know what? There's a little patch. Before I move forward, northwards. Check this out. Oh! Yeah, we don't want to miss something like this. Maybe this is the other piece of the helm. A few odds and ends lie scattered by the path. There appears to have been a struggle here, but the evidence is half buried under a thin blanket of snow. Wisps of essence hover in the chilly air. Inspect the area first. An empty pack lies in the snow. It's been torn nearly in two. Also, muddy tracks churn the ground. It's difficult to discern their shape or number, but they appear to lead north. That's good, we're heading that way. Reach out to the essence. The soul fragment plunges you into a memory. Your name is Ygadr. Oh, I'll say that. You've never been more than 20 miles from home, let alone to the White March, and yet you've been climbing steadily higher for a week now. The air is too thin, your clothes are too light, and you've barely got another 3 days' worth of food with you. But you've never felt better. You've only had a handful of fainting spells since you began your journey. You've had as many in a single day before. But the dreams have been the best part. Despite the frozen rocky ground and the screeching winds, sleep has found you each night and brought you visions of majestic peaks wrapped in snow. The cold is but a sweet ache in your bones. And as you hike into the wind, you feel that ache spreading along with the certainty that you're getting closer to him, or her, your soul twin. A stranger whose soul mirrors your own, one of the few people in Aora who could understand the constant torment of a split soul, and the only person who could help you relieve it. Something approaches through the shroud of snow ahead. You feel a throbbing presence like a heartbeat through linen, and you know. The vision ends abruptly. You find yourself staring at Ygadr's scattered belongings while his elation ebbs from your veins. That's a bummer. As his essence fades from you, you feel his eagerness dissolve into disappointment until that all that remains is the emptiness of a meaningless death. Ah, sad. Ygadr came to the White March searching for his soul twin, but somebody killed him in the Lonely Mountain Passes. I found the final wisps of his soul in the wilds east of Stalwart. Whoever killed him didn't leave much behind. I saw tracks leading north. I might find some trace of Ygadr or his murderer in that direction. And I'll bet when I meet the murderer, if this person actually says the person's name, it will not be Ygadr. It will be pronounced differently. Well, we've explored quite a bit of this land, and we have a good 10 minutes before we have to call in an episode, so let's go. Things are so interesting. Are they created by the Lagufaeth, or they just took up residence in this area and left these hills here? I mean, what are you going to do with them? Knock them over?
Quickly and quietly.
Well, up here could be this murderer and a Lagufaeth and the pearl that we're looking for. Make sure we all have the correct weapons selected, yes. Boom.
Following your lead.